Well, growing up with my sister was, I don't know, at first I was the pest. I used to pester her a lot when I was growing up, but then we grew into being very close. Actually, we were roommates in college for about 3 years, and then we did other things, and it was really a sad day whenever she had to leave, and I was enough to fend for myself.
But I basically left after school. I wanted to experience other places. I moved to San Francisco, moved to Miami, Florida, and actually that move to Miami was really to be closer to my culture. And my parents being from the Caribbean, I was able to still be an American, but be close to the food, be close to at one hop, skip, jumping away from the island. So that was a great experience as well.
Now, originally I had gotten into the restaurant business to maybe open a restaurant in the Caribbean. You know, because of my my passion towards the Caribbean, maybe caused me to want to live out there, you know, because I'd visit it from time to time. I thought I was actually going to open up an American restaurant in the Caribbean, actually.
My brother, who's my partner and my best friend, he's been in the restaurant industry since I can remember. He started, you know, dishwashing and worked his way through into management. So I just told him, like, you can do this. I actually 1 year bought him books of how to start a restaurant for Christmas. That was his Christmas present, a library of books.
You know, males with some kind of machismo, sometimes you think you can do it yourself. And so I worked in the business for a long time. And so I cracked them up, I guess, during the budgeting process of making up the business plan.
His wife, my sister-in-law, she knew that this was his dream too. So she just started writing a business plan. And we found this space. I don't know, she contacted a real estate agent and we found this awesome space. And it just kind of grew from there. It was just, this is where we need to be. This is what we need to do. And we kind of willed it to happen.
Well, like I said, the whole thing just, you know, was based on the Caribbean concept. And so it really didn't take much to figure out exactly what we wanted to do. We had, you know, we were pretty directed and pretty focused on the Caribbean.
So we really took some traditional family recipes and, you know, our appetizers, for instance, we have the crab backs. That's something really signature of our island of Dominica. So we took my mom's recipe and my brother pretty much made it be what it is. So that's an example of something that, you know, we just ate growing up. And to see people enjoy what we've been just immersed in our whole lives, it's just such a great experience.
I was most popular. Obviously, they started off with the ones they're most comfortable with, you know, which are basically going to be the jerk chicken and Cuban. Then from there, they ventured out to different things, and one of the things that they liked a lot was the Jamaican beef patties, and then also the lobster thermidor, which isn't necessarily Caribbean, but it was brought over from the Europeans to the Caribbean.
Well, actually, my mom came up with the name. It's the name of the national bird of Dominica. And it's the Cicero parrot. It's the only place in the world you can find this parrot. It lives in the tropical rainforest of Dominica. And it really spoke to what we're trying to be. The bird is beautiful, it's vibrant, it's colorful. It has if you can notice throughout the restaurant, all the colors are inspired by the bird itself.
Well, the bar items, I have to give a lot of credit to our mixologist, you know, Victor C. He does a wonderful job behind the bar and he creates some you know, wonderful, delightful cocktails.
Oh yeah, don't forget about the cocktails. You know, we love to have a good time and it was really important that our drink menu really explored that part of the cuisine as well.
It really makes a big difference to me how the guests feel and so forth. And you know, with me, we consider them not to be patients, we consider them guests in our home.
Actually, the biggest satisfaction I get is when I go around and talk to tables and I hear, we just got back from the Caribbean and this reminds me of our trip. Or we got married last year in Jamaica and you know, we're here for our anniversary because we want to re-experience that. Like that to me is really the joy of being here. We can offer that experience and be part of their memories. I really think that it makes it all worth it and we want to be here for a long time.